Hello students, welcome in electronics lecture. In the previous lecture, what we have seen zener characteristics of the zener diode. There is a load current and line voltage. Okay. Today we are going to see the IV characteristics. IV characteristics of zener diode. See, this is the graph for zener diode. This is the voltage and this is the current I. This is the voltage V. See what happened? This is the forward region. This is what? Forward region. This zener diode works in three regions. Forward region, and this is leakage region. Okay. IV characteristics. I indicates current. V is the voltage. Voltage and current characteristics of what? Zener diode. So it comes under the regulation. We have seen what we have seen in the power supply basic block diagram. Yes. In the transformer, first block, second rectifier, third filter, and last is the regulator. Why the regulator is used? Why there is a need of regulator? We have seen in the previous lecture. Why the regulator is used? Yes, regulator is used to give the constant DC voltage, regulate constant DC voltage, non-stop voltage, or continuous voltage we will get at the output of the circuit. Therefore, we require what? Regulator. So, without regulator, no doubt we get the DC voltage at output, but it is not regulated, it is not constant in the filter circuit. Therefore, after filter, we use the regulator circuit. This regulator circuit gives the regulated constant DC output. Okay? So, for that, we have to first see the zener as a regulator circuit. So, before going to see the zener as a regulator, we have to see the characteristics, its current characteristics and voltage characteristics of the zener diode. How zener diode works, how zener diode is used, why it is used. Just first we will see the its characteristics, then we will go for the circuit diagram for the zener as a voltage regulator. Okay, so here IV characteristics of zener diode. What happened in this graph? See, so this is the characteristics graph of the zener diode. The question will be asked, draw the graph for the IV graph characteristics of the zener diode. So we have to draw like this. So these have the three regions: forward region, leakage region, and breakdown region. So whatever the first point I will tell you, this diode, it is a simply which diode? PN junction diode. What is a PN junction diode? Yes, there are so many types of diode: PN junction diode, zener diode, light emitting diode, yes, photodiode, Schottky diode, types of diode we have seen in the 11th standard. So what is the PN junction diode? PNN, positive and negative, which is having one layer. So this is simply PN junction diode. If it is, see, this zener diode is nothing but the p-n-junction diode like this. This is the p region and this is the n region. This is what p region and n region. The symbol of this p-n-junction diode. This is what? Sorry, symbol of Zener diode. So what I will say in the Zener diode, it is a simple p-n junction diode and its depletion layer. See, this is what p-n junction diode, this p and n junction diode, and this is what depletion layer. Depletion layer is what narrow. This depletion layer is very narrow in this, so it can be narrowed by adding its doping level. Doping level, by increasing its doping level, can use its depletion is very narrow. So first tell me, what is doping? Doping means what? What is the concept of doping? Adding impurity in the pure atom is called as the doping. What is the doping? Adding impurity in the pure atom. For example, suppose you have one glass of water, pure water or filtered water. In that water, you are adding some sand. In the pure water, filtered water, you have one glass, in that you have the filtered water, you are adding some sand in that water, its process is called as a doping. What? That process is called as a doping, means adding impurity into the pure atom is called as a doping. So by adding or increasing the doping level, you will get its depletion layer is very narrow. Okay, so this Zener diode is what? It is a p-n junction diode. Its doping level or it having a narrow what? Depletion layer. Okay, and this p-n junction diode or Zener diode, how it works? How it will become Zener diode? If its voltage is above 2 volt. 200 volt, if you increase its voltage, if you increase the voltage 2 volt to 200 volt, then simply p-n junction diode will work as a Zener diode. Yes, it will work as a Zener diode. So how Zener diode is work, how p-n junction diode is work, we'll see. Okay, so this is simply, but Zener diode is what? It is simply p-n junction diode. Layer is very narrow, so we can increase it by increasing its doping level, we'll get the narrow depletion layer. So that if it is from 2 volt to 200 volt, then it will work as a Zener diode. So Zener diode is now come here in this region. So Zener diode always work in this region, breakdown region. Zener diode is used in the reverse bias. You know the forward bias and reverse bias? We have seen in the rectifier circuit. Forward bias, reverse bias. P-n junction diode works only in the forward bias. When current flow from positive to negative, it is called as a forward bias. When current flow from negative to positive, reverse bias, means reverse condition. Means reverse, back, is called as a reverse. Okay? Forward and reverse. So this is having three regions. First region is what? Forward region. Second is what? This leakage region. Leakage region having the leakage current or reverse current. And third is what? Breakdown region. Breakdown region. These are the three regions in which the what happens zener will be work. Okay, so in forward region, diode will simply act as a p-n junction diode. How the p-n junction diode works in the forward bias condition? So in this condition or in this area, this zener diode will act as a simply ordinary diode or simply p-n junction diode. So it will work on the, it will conduct the 0.7 volt only, just like our semiconductor diode, p-n junction diode. This zener will be in forward region, it will act as a simply ordinary diode. Okay, so this forward region says that in this region, this zener will act as a simply ordinary or p-n junction diode. It will be conduct only on the 0.7 volt. Okay, so what is leakage region now? This, suppose this is a 0 volt, some voltage is here, positive values are here, negative values of voltage are there, here positive values of current is there, and here negative value of current is there. Okay, now leakage region means which region is called leakage region? This region is called leakage region. This means what? From 0 volt to the breakdown region. From 0 volt to breakdown region, this area is there, that area is called as the leakage region. Or in this leakage region, reverse current is there. Reverse current will flow. Okay, in this area, reverse current will flow. Leakage means what? Reverse. From 0 to breakdown region, this much area is called as a leakage area. So last is what? Breakdown region. See what happens in breakdown region. Zener diode is only work in this region. Which region? Breakdown region. Zener diode is work in the only breakdown region. How it works? You can see in this graph. It is start from 0 to some particular value of voltage. This is what? Voltage. From 0 to particular value of voltage, it will increase after particular voltage. Suppose this voltage, after particular voltage means from here, it's the current. This is what? The current start increasing and it will be constant. This current start increasing and this voltage is constant. In this level only, here only the voltage will be constant. At particular level, the voltage will be constant and current will be sharply. And at that point, where the voltage is constant and that voltage is called as VZ. That is the zener voltage. So that voltage is called as VZ. That is the zener voltage. And from that voltage VZ, how much is the current is called as the IZ. That is what is the zener current or testing zener current, the IZT. Means at particular level, when voltage is constant and current is increased, at that point, the which point is constant voltage giving, that voltage is called as the zener voltage, and when the current is constant at particular level is called as the IZ. What is the IZ? IZ is the zener current, and when is the after some IZ it will start increasing. So this is the maximum value of the current, is called as what? IZM. M indicates its maximum value of the zener current. Okay, so this is the main characteristics or IV characteristics of what? Zener diode. Okay, so what will you write? Question will be asked, write the IV characteristics of the zener diode. First of all, you have to draw this graph. In graph, you have to show three regions: forward region, leakage region, and breakdown region. In forward region, what happened? Zener diode will simply act as a p-n junction diode, or it will be conduct on 0.7 volt only. Okay, In the gauge region from 0 volt to breakdown region, this area is called as a leakage region. In this leakage region, current, reverse current will be flowed. Okay. So, in breakdown region, third region is breakdown region. In breakdown region, only the Zener diode works. Zener diode will not work here. It will work only here. Here means where? In the breakdown region. So, how it works? It starts working from 0 volt. It starts increasing the voltage. At particular voltage, it will be remain constant. It will not go forward. It will remain constant. It will work. It will, the current starts increasing at the constant voltage. This constant voltage is called as the VZ, that is the Zener voltage. And the constant current is called as the IZ. At that point, at the where the voltage is constant, at that point, how much is the current? That current is called as the IZ, that is the Zener current. And that from that point, current starts increasing. The maximum level where the current is reached, at that maximum level is called as the IZM. All of you understand this IV characteristics of Zener diode? It's very important. It has asked so many times. So, if you want to know the regulation, you have to first know the characteristics of this Zener diode. Then we'll go for the circuit diagram. Okay? So, what is the current characteristics and voltage characteristics of the Zener diode? It's given here. All of you clear this? Yes? Now, we'll see its rating. Rating means what? First, rating is of three types. First rating is what? Power dissipation. First rating is what? Power dissipation. Second is for maximum current. Maximum current or I dissipation. And third is maximum resistance or R rating. Maximum resistance rating, maximum current dissipation or rating. There are three types of rating: power dissipation, maximum current rating and maximum resistance rating. First we'll see the power dissipation. Yes, first we'll see the power dissipation. What happens in power dissipation? Power is what? P is nothing but what? Yes, what is power? All of you know, it is the product of voltage and current. Okay, power is what? It is the product of voltage and current. Which diode we are using here? Power of Zener diode is the what product of Zener voltage and Zener current? It is called as what? Power dissipation. In this power dissipation, it is the product of what? Voltage and current. And Zener diode will work in the breakdown region only. Zener diode will work in the breakdown region. So, power dissipation is nothing but it is the product of voltage and current. It's the product of which voltage? Zener voltage and Zener current. And that Zener will work in the, yes? Zener will work in the breakdown region. Its rating is 1 upon 4 watt to 50 watt. 1 upon 4 watt to 50 watt. Comes the, it's the power rating. Okay? It's having the range 1 upon 4 watt to 50 watt in the power dissipation. Now, second we'll see the maximum current. I'll rough it. Second point is what? Maximum current dissipation or रेटिंग, मैक्सिमम करंट रेटिंग. व्हाट इज आई? इज अ करंट. आई इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? पावर अपॉन वी, वेयर पावर इज ऑफ व्हाट? जीनर डायोड. ऑफ मैक्सिमम पावर ऑफ जीनर डायोड एंड डिवाइड बाय वोल्टेज ऑफ जीनर डायोड इज कॉल्ड एज द करंट रेटिंग. इट्स करंट रेटिंग मीन्स व्हाट? इट एक्सेप्ट और इट हैंडल मैक्सिमम करंट विदाउट एक्सीडिंग. व्हाट? इट हैंडल मैक्सिमम करंट विदाउट एक्सीडिंग इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट? मैक्सिमम करंट रेटिंग. In this maximum current rating, what happened? It not include without exceeding means it included, not required any external circuit. So in maximum current rating, I is equal to power upon voltage. That is the PZM upon VZ, or it handles maximum current without exceeding voltage. Okay. So in third is what? Resistance rating. Here is what? Resistance rating. We know V equal to I into R. Okay? Then R means what? Resistance is equal to, yes, voltage upon current. So this R is what? Zener resistance, zener voltage and zener current. So what happened? This may be the current for resistance and impedance is same. Yes, current limiting or rating is for resistance and for impedance it is same. Therefore, this Z of Z means it is for impedance, this is for resistance, is equal to delta of VZ divided by delta of IZ. Means what? It is ratio of zener voltage to ratio of the, yes, current, zener current. Okay, so this is the resistance rating of the zener diode. There are three types of rating. First rating is the power dissipation rating. Second is the maximum current rating, and third is what? It's a resistance rating. So current is maximum current rating is what? P is equal to I is equal to P upon V, and resistance is equal to resistance and impedance is same. It handles the same current. Therefore it is what? R is equal to V upon I. Next we are going to see the circuit diagram for the zener diode or zener diode as a voltage regulator. I will put this graph as it is because we want it here later on for explanation of the zener diode. So zener diode as a voltage regulator, we are going to see next. Zener diode as a voltage regulator. First, we will draw the circuit diagram. This is unregulated power supply. Unregulated power supply. Which is given to this RS. RS means what? It's the source resistance. Then we'll connect the zener diode here and we will connect the load resistance RL, and we will gauge across the RL is constant or regulated output voltage, that is. So here is positive, negative. Voltage is there, Vs, that is source voltage. This is the Rs, source resistance. Where current flow from here is Is, the source current. And here is what? Zener diode is flowing through this is the Iz, that is the Zener current. And this is the Zener diode and voltage across this is the Vz and this the Ra. So current flow from this is the In. Okay, this is the circuit diagram for the what? Zener diode as a voltage regulator. So I will write first the indications. Rs is what? Source resistance. Vs is input voltage, input source voltage. Iz is the Zener current, current across the Zener diode. And Vz is also the voltage across Zener diode. IL is the load current. V0 is the output voltage. So this is what? Unregulated power supply. So first thing what we have to see in this Zener diode as a regulator. As a regulator we want this circuit. Okay. So what is the purpose of our this circuit is? We want the regulated output voltage. Here which voltage we require here is the regulated constant voltage. So main function or main purpose of Zener diode as a regulator is what? At the output we require the regulated or constant voltage. Whether there is a variation in the unregulated power supply or there is a variation in the load resistance. If there is a variation in the load resistance, then also we want this output as a regulated. If there is a variation in the input voltage or power supply, then also we require the constant regulated DC output voltage. The first point is what? We want the regulated output voltage, whether there is a variation in input or in RL. We want the output voltage as a constant. Okay. Second thing is what? See, this Vs is connecting in series with this Rs. Means Rs and Vs is Rs is and Vs are in series connection. Then this Zener diode is, that is Vz, is parallel with this Rl. So this is the construction of this diagram. Okay. So unregulated power supply is there. This source voltage is connected in series with the source resistance and Zener voltage is connected with parallel with this load resistance Rl. Okay. So if there is a question may be asked like this. Write a note or explain Zener diode as a voltage regulator. First point you have to draw this circuit diagram. Then you have to write the notifications. Then you have to write the construction of this diagram. In construction what will you write? First point you will write. You get first point you will write how it is. In Zener diode you get the regulated output. Whether there is a variation in load resistance Ra or whether there is a variation in the input supply. Second point what you will write in the construction, Rs is in series with this source resistance, is in series with this voltage source or Vs. Rs is connected in series with this Vs. And third point, what you will write? This Vz means what? Zener voltage is parallel with this load resistance RL. Okay. So this is the construction of this diagram. Now we'll see the working, how it works. Working of this figure. So first is what IS. This IS is equal to VS minus VZ divided by RS. This is the main formula. Keep it in mind because so many sums or numericals have asked on this formula. So this IS is what? It is the difference between VS and VZ. What is VS? It's the input voltage. VZ is the zener voltage and RS is what? Source resistance. So this IS is equal to VS minus VZ upon RS. See, now we'll see the exact working for the voltage and current rating. What will be the effect of voltage here and how we get the constant regulated output voltage? Okay. So our purpose of this diagram is we want the regulated output voltage. So what happens, see, if this VS and RS will be increased, if this VS is increased, RS will increase, what happens, this IS will also increase and it will flow through this IZ, but I will be constant and we get the constant output voltage, therefore V0 will be constant. Okay, if VS is increased, IS will be obviously increased, then IZ will be, it flow through this IZ zener diode, then IL will be what happened, it will be constant, the output will get in the constant. So if VS and RS is decreased, then also IS will decrease, but at that time also IL will be constant and we get output as a constant. Output voltage is a constant. Okay. If this is what the voltage working as a load voltage or voltage variation we have seen. Now we see the current variation. For this current variation we require this graph. Therefore I have to keep it here. So in current variation what happened? Zener will work in, yes, which region? Breakdown region. So here first point is what? Vz is the constant. Okay, this is the constant voltage. It's called as a Vz, that is a zener voltage, where current is increasing. See, this current is start increasing from here and this is the, see, this is the current is start increasing at the sharp knee, okay, and voltage is constant. So current is start changes or increases in this region. So what happened, Vz is constant, means this Vz is constant and current start increasing, in this condition what happened, if this RS and IS will be decrease, then what happened? IZ is also increase, decrease, and at that time what happened? At output voltage, IL is constant, therefore at output V0 is the regulated output voltage. Regulated or constant output we are getting it here. Okay? If RS and IS is constant, there is no effect of this thing. So IL will be constant. This IS will be constant. Sorry, this IZ is there. IS will be constant. Therefore, we get the output as a regulated output voltage. Okay. All of you understand these two conditions. This is the current variation and voltage variation. Or this is what the working of this circuit diagram working of this zener diode as a regulator. This is the main formula for the zener as a voltage regulator. All of you understand this? What we have seen in this lecture? We have seen the IV characteristics of zener diodes. Its rating. Rating is of three types. What? Three types. First is what? Power rating. Second is power dissipation rating. Second is what? Current rating. And third is the resistance rating. Okay? Resistance and impedance is same for the current rating. Okay? So this is the IV characteristics. In IV characteristics, zener diode. In forward region, zener diode simply acts as a ordinary diode, or if the it will conduct on the 0.7 volt only. So zener will work only in the breakdown region. It starts working from 0 volt. It starts increasing the voltage. At particular voltage, it will be constant. That constant voltage is called as a VZ. That is a zener voltage. And at that point, what is the current is called as the IZ. That is the constant zener, resting zener current. And zener current start increasing, and maximum current is called as the IZM. So this is the IV characteristics of the zener diode. Next we have seen the circuit diagram or zener diode as a voltage regulator. In zener diode as a voltage regulator, what happened? This the unregulated power supply is there. Then source resistance is connected in series with this source voltage, that is RS is in series this with VS, and this VZ is parallel with this RL, and we get the output voltage at the across this RL. Okay, so this is the main formula. From this formula you have to solve the sums or examples. Examples has asked so many times, and it will be asked in the exam, so you will solve by this equation. IS is equal to VS minus VZ upon RS. Okay, so construction, how can you write the construction? RS is the source resistance, IS is the source current, VS is the source voltage, VZ is the zener voltage, IZ is the zener current, IL is the load current, RL is the load resistance, and V0 is the output DC voltage. Okay, so RS is connected in series this VS, VZ is parallel with this RL. Now the working in the two conditions, load voltage, sorry, in the voltage variations, and second is the current variation. In voltage variation, what we have seen, if VS and RS is increased, obviously IS will increase, and but IL will be constant, and will get output voltage as a constant. If RS is decreased, VS is decreased, IS will be decreased. Okay, but this IL is constant, and therefore we will get the output voltage as a constant in the voltage variation. In the current variation, what happened? VZ is constant. We have seen in the graph. VZ is constant, but current is start increasing, or current is in changes. Current is changes, and voltage is constant. Therefore, this RS and IZ will be decreased. Then also IS will be constant. If IS is constant, constant voltage will get at the output. Okay. If RS is constant, IZ is constant, then we will get the output voltage constant because IS is constant in that condition also. So these are the two conditions, voltage variation and current variation of this zener diode. So this zener will act in the load regulation and line regulation. This zener will act in the load regulation and line regulation. What is load regulation? What is line regulation? We have seen in the previous lecture. Okay. In the load regulation, we have seen what we have seen. RL load regulation is equal to what? VNL minus VFL divided by VFL. What is VNL? What is VFL? Yes, it is the voltage across no load current, voltage across full load current. Okay, in the load regulation, what is in the line regulation? In the line regulation, voltage should be within some range. It's called as the line regulation. So this in the zener diode works in the load regulation and line regulation only. Okay, all of you understand this? This is a very simple concept, and it has asked in the exam. So all of you clear this point? Thank you.